when it breaks apart. The satellites fall. We'll be laughing up above when this black hole swallows us all. Swallows us all.
Now, when I was out in Canada, with this cunt Bobby fucking 18-wheeler Ricks,
I realized something.
This cunt is the greatest battle rapper I have ever seen. Look at him. 31 years old, bit of a beard, and he still doesn't look a fucking day over 17. And I know that he doesn't use moisturizer. Fuck that, Bobby Rex is a fucking bloke's bloke. When Amby asked me if I think I'd beat him, I said, do I? Fuck, bro, that's Ross Club Rex. There is absolutely no hope. Yes. See, I know that he'll prepare for me because he fucking loves me like a brother. Not only that, I heard he had a lackluster performance last week on another league. He won't turn up today against me and have another. Real shit, I'm just fucking keeping it real. I fucking hate liars. I told him. Yeah, book me flight and hotel, I'll still put in a blinded performance. I ain't here to fuck spiders.
Yes, man. Yes.
That's when I decided that I'd tell him the truth. Now, Amby didn't believe me right away, but when we was coming back from Canada, after King of the Dot, where we both absolutely fucking killed it, by the way, me and Bobby, we decide to play a prank. We swap passports and plane tickets, and he goes and stands in the fucking queue to my flight to Australia. The security fall for it, and instead of telling them it's a prank, this fucking idiot carries on inside the gate. I'm fucking stood there with my jaw dropped watching him walk off, and just before he gets out of sight, the fucking idiot turns around, smiles and waves. You fucking drugger. Now, I had to go and live his fucking life, and believe me, Bobby Rex's life was great. But you have to bear in mind, bro, how much you fucking pissed me off. So the first thing I did when I landed in England is I fucking quit your job. Now, a couple of fucking things that you might need to know. You get public transport now because your car got scrapped a couple fucking weeks ago. Also, your girlfriend left you recently. Well, bro, she was getting on my tits, and I'll be surprised if you missed her. And at the end of the day, it's better to have loved than lost and to have not fucked her sister. Now, I'm sure there's one more thing I need to tell you, cunt. What is it now? Let me see. Yeah, when you fucked her sister, she gave you an STD. Fuck your dad.
I said I'm back in the UK. Hey.
Yeah. Hey, look, I know the flights cost a pretty penny, so I'm just stoked that y'all booked Dunner's tickets. Especially when I'm sure you heard the story of the last time that I come to visit. You know, after a couple minutes of touching in, I hit up old mate Raptor thinking we were going to catch up for a quiet cup of lifting, blacked out and woke up 5 days later with a full-blown fucking drug addiction. Fucking then, just when I'd come good and recovered from the last time that I come to kick it, well, fuck me then. I thought it'd be a good idea when I was in Toronto to catch up with this drunken dickhead. And basically after 3 solid days of getting munted with him, I'm not sure how the hell I'm standing next to him right now in Mother England, when by all rights, both of us should still be in Canada, locked up in a bloody prison. What I am trying to say is, all of you mad cunts are a bad influence, something wicked. Before I met you lot, I was young and different. Fucking shit. I said, all of you mad cunts are a bad influence, something wicked. Before I met you lot, I was young and different. buff and chiseled with a luscious figure. My skin complexion had a lovely shimmer, but... but after hanging out with you, Raptor and Lordy, with all the stuff we're sniffing, I end up on the flight home having sudden twitches like a junkie sentence. I said, after hanging out with you, Raptor and Lordy, with all the stuff we're sniffing, I end up on the flight home having sudden twitches like a junkie symptoms, because I've got more drugs in my fucking system than a 1980s Russian gymnast. I get on a wave a couple times a year. This motherfucker don't stop. And I guess that's why your voice always sound a little husky from the snow, dog. Be the type to go swap a head for a coke rock. You're the type to go swap head for a coke rock anytime a dealer calls your phone, Bob. Gets the ring and he's on his knees for the white girl like most prop. The best in your country got on drugs and fell to fuck off. And now you top tier. So what? Another Mancunian cokehead battle rapper. That's typically average, man. Joe Bloggs. We both looking old in the face, but I see the filler in your lines like Botox, because all you got is fake front on the beak like a nose job. You fucking drugger. Now what? I'm meant to be scared of this bloody rockhead. If you're a heavy hitter, you can go ahead and take your best shot then. I don't care what's said. Bob Rex is not hench. Don't think he gone flex just because he looks like Ross Kemp. Acting like you some globetrotting jet setter on an international conquest, but if I feed you them lines at World Dom, you'd still be passed out on that soft bed. So I'll creep in your house while you're napping and put hands around Bob's neck until it stops breath for no reason, kill him in the crib just for sleeping like cop death. So just remember, I'm a generous guy, but when we're getting off our head tonight, you was in hospital for that shit like a month ago. So I guess either way I'm bringing deadly lines, because once we start getting high, this dinosaur will face extinction Armageddon style, and you'll see how one rock kick can wipe out the Rex for a second time. Because you got so much of that shit coursing through the veins of your body that you don't just do drugs, drugs do you. So you can't just say it's a hobby, because if cocaine could talk, it would say that it probably needs to check itself in a rehab and lay off the bobby.
If you believe he fed me lines for my battle in Canada, okay, but I can't see the only lines he has ever fed me. There we go. I gotta tell you how far I was Dundee in the first round, didn't it? That's because we look so much alike, I could actually catch his flight, go to his house and climb inside his comfortable bed. I'd lie there right beside his wife, and she wouldn't even notice the difference, apart from the fact his cock was now twice as wide. I can take over your life just to fuck with your head, and if I decide I do want to take the mick out of you, then believe me, I won't stop. I will be done when you're dead. Nah, I delivered it a bit shit, but listen. It could have been better. And never mind telling me this is business and you've only come for the bread, because I know for a fact, 100%, that the only thing you've been paid is a bottle of Jim Beams off shops to go and get drunk with your friends. Yous have been killing it recently. Yeah, they've been killing it recently. Well, today is gonna be the day that run comes to an end. I am killing him easily. I will rip him to pieces. I'll kick in his teeth. I'll fucking piss in his teacups. I'll spit on his pizzas. I'll get on the THC mixtape and I'll diss him on features. I'm a different breed, bro. I tell you, fuck with me and I promise you will die. And killing you will hurt me so much because it'll feel like committing suicide. And if I do attack you, afterwards, if somehow you survive, I'll press charges against you for beating me up. And you'll get a 2 to 5. And you'll get a 2 to 5. Who's a grass? You grassed yourself up. You got bipolar disorder. He's asked for help, bro. It's not really crazy, though. It's just that his parents dropped a clangor by putting me in a position I can make it look that way by giving birth to my doppelganger. Yeah. I have a lot of anger. Yeah. I don't want to bang you, so do not be irritating, because one false move from this cunt and I'll clean his ass out. No colonic irrigation. Surely now, yeah, this is a short round, but surely 2-0 to me. Well done, you tried. God bless you. It's not your fault you came up against Chester's Brock Lesnar. Oh, I have taken the boomerang out of his ass and beat him over the head with it.
Now, after watching the Code Red Cypher, bro, I'm going to ask the deal. Are you Jamaican? are you like half Jamaican?
Oh,
you are? See, motherfucker, that's how I know you aren't for real. You think dropping all that patois is still acting like a bad boy artist still when you look like you could get cast in a neo-Nazi film? When you look like you could get cast in a neo-Nazi film or fit in perfectly doing marching drills up and down the main drag of Charlottesville? Like, how the fuck are you Jamaican if the pigment's missing? I guess you got a skin condition. Nah, with all the National Front and his disposition, I guess they got this skin condition. Now look, I'm from Australia, so I'm used to hearing all these bigots whinging with their shit opinions. I just thought this country had a different vision. You mean to tell me this is England? Because you close your eyes and hear him rap, you probably think he got some dreads. Then you open up and see that polished head looking like he came fresh from a Romper Stomper set. I don't care if you're the highest view Ronald yet. Fozzie Rex is not a threat. I said, I don't care if you're the highest viewed Ronald yet. Fozzie Rex is not a threat. Cut, the only time you're dropping bombs, it's got an N on top of it. You should get slapped for that. I'll take any punches that this packy bashing cracker has. Fucking go for it. Start swinging on your Chevy Chase. That's Caddyshack. You can get rocked harder than an Akadaka track and catch the biggest hit when I come back in black and see an Aussie going ice cold on the streets of London like the last time Bon Scott had a nap. See, you might scare these nerds that are into battle rap. But me, I'll just stab the twat. Brass clot. I'll leave this pussy bleeding out. You'll need a maxi pad when I go across your stomach with a massive shank and make you grab your abs like maternity happy snaps and have your guts hanging out your shirt in front of all these battle heads like Classic Pat. Spill your fucking guts, Kent. See if the man can die with honor like a samurai. Acting like a monster, stick a piece of metal through your neck like Dr. Frankenstein. So you from Gunchester where them cannons fire. Can't go ahead and grab the nine. If he has text, one dagger slice will turn him to a human sacrifice. See, that's ancient history, because it's like you're going back in time with them stagnant rhymes. What they said, an evolution of Mike along camera like it was Jackson 5, the black or white, there's a big difference. Because while you were asking the league if they're going to cover you for your taxi ride, bro, I was asking the league if they was going to cover me for an alibi. Someone better tell this rock peddling Tom Metzger to not flex with the wrong gestures. Knock heads till he drops dead and I ends up with a long sentence. Face truth, no fake moves. I want pull punches. We're not wrestling. Catch hands on the real. Count if we rumble, then I'm Brock Lesnar. I said it's motherfucking Ozchester. That shit the grey from cradle. Pay to play and I'll put money on this hit like a major label. But yo, A1.
What up?
See, I know you love the Bible, bro. So I'm gonna put a spin on one of them ancient fables when I cave my brother's skull in while I'm high on sniff. Cocaine and Abel. Yeah. Yeah.
Stop talking about the patois shit. You're making me angry. And outside, I'll find the Caribbean. I ain't gonna lie, I'm disappointed, Dunners. See, I thought that we was more than boys now, tight to the point with brothers. So when Ambi asks you who you want to battle here, considering the wide array and choice of others, why the fuck did you say my name? Because now, while you're here, the only time remaining, night and day, you'll have to try and avoid the ruckus, because you have pissed me off to the point that I no longer want to clash. I want to go outside for a one-on-one, tops off, shoes off, on the grass. Yeah. I thought the next time we meet up after Canada, we'd do a load of drugs and go out on the lash. Now if this cunt really wants some good cocaine in England, even if he's got the cash, just think of the word masturbation. because that means just to give the nub the bash. Wanker. Go fuck yourself. Real shit, though. Real shit, though, because don't you see, it's the Cain enabling him in the first place to think that got him thinking he can kill his bro. Oh, ah, the delivery fucked. The Cain enabled battle's well better than this. Real shit, though. Don't you see, it's the Cain enabling him in the first place that's got him thinking he can kill his bro. The next bit.
Tell him, Bob.
You're making me hungry. No. kill his bro. Fuck. Don't do this.
You got it, bro.
Go on, Bob. You got it.
Take your time, bro.
Come on, Bobby. Come on, Bob.
Take your time.
Sick! Go up, Bobby. It's the Cain enabling him. Sake, man. Oh, nah, I can't. Sake! Oh, shit!
You got it now.
Fuck! Is that even gonna have the same effects now? Because I'm supposed to go. That was a stupidly good bar. Kill his bro.
That was a stupid game.
But coming up, they said I'm all performance and my pen is so amateur. Then they had to watch me rise above the pack like Joe Danihal. Now they might not get this in the room.
Right.
I might prefer if I stick to fucking references of Noel Gallagher. Okay then. Tell these two Aussie cunts to get back on them high flying birds, fuck off and don't look back in anger, you. Yes! Yeah! And if you do, I promise the both of y'all will batter you. Hang on, everyone's wondering why the fuck's he mad at Vega? To be honest, I'm not the guy's actually safe, I just back my mates up. Shout out Frankie Fraser.
Yeah!
Now, people in the crowd, may I please ask a favour? Think back to when he battled Innuendo. There's one line that his dickhead said. He said, Innuendo's birthstone is crystal meth. Yeah. Everyone reacted like, that's hot. But see if I get a big reaction, because this is the exact same line. Your birthstone is crack rock.
Hey, hey.
It's not that good, really, is it? fucking forgot the shit again. Go back to. Fuck the battle! Might as well just fucking fight him. Take him outside and write him off. If you see me battling King of the Dot, did you remember I was wearing this black and white stripy top?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, for wearing that, half of Australia now think that I'm a knob. Fucking idiot.
Oh, it's so funny.
And the thing is, he's not even Australian, so we don't care, he's Tasmanian. You know, I fucked it up, right, I'm off. Blah, 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 blah.
That's a good job.
Well, have a bloody look at you. Standing there all mean and hench. And it works on all these other dickheads, doesn't it? Is she a different kettle of fish to me, my friend? Cause I'm a different breed to them in the scene I rap. I've been the best. I beat Cortez, Ice and Cannons, how the hell could he contend? And you had a good run the last 12 months or so.
I mean, you headlined a GZ event, you moved up the ladder locally, battled Dialect and Tony D, but then you got given me. And up until now, yeah, you've achieved success, but once I'm done exposing you, your poser, that's when all your dreams will end. Fucking Bobby Godiva over here. Yeah. I'm about to shed some light on your writing like when Shox was catching heat from Jem. See, the reason we ain't seen his pen is because he spits bars that other people said. So I'd know why the fuck chalked out when it put me against this thieving pleb. Fuck Bobby, I'm on his ghostwriter. Y'all need to set me up with Phoebe Rex. She's a vet. Well, I saw your shit, but still don't mean she the dopest, because you know I got a little girl too. And I might have just bought some lines and she wrote him. Yeah. See, I approached her for some bars while she was watching telly on her lonesome, and you know what she said to say, cunt? Leave me alone, Dadder, I'm trying to watch Frozen. I said, nah. Yeah, you're gonna help me come up with some mean stuff to say about my next opponent. And next thing you know, well, she started singing, "Do You Wanna Build a Snowman?" I pressed pause on the DVD like, "No, baby girl, you need to focus." She said, "Dada," so it's either this, we have a tea party, or play My Little Ponies. So we had a motherfucking tea party. I said we had a motherfucking tea party. And trust me, the shit's mad, dude. I was hanging with Twilight Sparkle and Rainbow Dash and was sick. I fucking Applejack and Pinkie Pie doing some sick dance moves like out. making a noise when they fucking click clack hoon. So while you were rolling up notes to sniff grams through, raiding gas and selling coke with your big man crew, I was hanging with some magical fucking horses in my kids' damn room. So while you were rolling up notes to sniff grams through, raiding gaffs and selling coke with your big man crew, I was hanging with some magical fucking horses in my kids' damn room, having a tea party with my daughter, because that's what big men do! You're a big man too. You're a big man too. I mean, shit, you're my twin brother. So if y'all got beef, I'm backing ya. Cause I am my brother's keeper. Even after they told me he's the challenger. But they trying to compare two brothers by the roles they see on camera. Like they turn Chris and Liam Hemsworth into Nolan Liam Gallagher. Whose fucking idea was this? Was it yours?
Yeah.
It's fucking yours, wasn't it? See, that gets me quite angry. To be honest, I take bloody offence to the shit you've tried, Ambi. I'm gonna get me brother here to bash you while I get pissed and fight Frankie. So you cunts learn to mind your own fucking business and stop trying to put a rift through my family. On the real, I am honoured you cunts flew me out to this event and I'm here, but ain't gonna be none of that usual best up in here, son, respected and feared done, because for the very first time in my battling career, bruv, respect where respect is due.
Yeah.
I would have got you a beer, cunt.